We're going to go to Washington now, where the White House is in cleanup mode as President Trump reverses his decision to award the G7 summit to his own hotel. And Acting Chief of Staff Mick Mulvaney tries to take back his admission that military aid to Ukraine was tied to political investigations sought by President Trump. Our senior White House correspondent Cecilia Vega has all the latest. Good morning, Cecilia.
Hey, George, good morning to you. A lot of damage control happening here at the White House this morning on the G7. I can't remember the last time we saw a backtrack from President Trump like we've seen on this one. This was his idea from the start, and now he is backing down in the face of bipartisan backlash. Overnight, President Trump fuming about the fallout over his plan to hold the G7 summit at his Florida resort. The president saying on Twitter he was forced to rescind the idea because of do-nothing Democrat fake news anger. An almost unheard-of reversal, the president blaming it on, quote, irrational hostility. Leaders from around the world, their staff and security, thousands of guests, paying to stay at the Trump family's 800-acre property, which has struggled financially. It sparked immediate backlash, not just from ethics watchdogs and Democrats, who signaled they would investigate, but even the White House counsel's office privately expressed reservations, as did some Republicans.
It shouldn't have been done in the first place. I know he loves his properties, and he loves having people to his properties, and he loves showing off those properties. I understand all that, but this just was an unforced error.
Aides insisted the president would not profit, saying he was simply being a showman.
At the end of the day, you know, he still considers himself to be in the hospitality business. He wanted to put on a show.
The president already facing multiple lawsuits accusing him of using his office for personal gain by taking payments from foreign officials and the U.S. government at properties like the Trump International Hotel, just blocks from the White House. The president's acting chief of staff, Mick Mulvaney, also backpedaling on his admission last week that there was indeed a quid pro quo in the president's phone call with Ukraine, now at the center of Democrats' impeachment inquiry.
And I have news for everybody. Get over it. There's going to be political influence in foreign policy.
In a head-spinning explanation on Fox, Mulvaney denied ever saying there was a quid pro quo, even though he acknowledged exactly that in that White House press conference last week.
So I recognize that folks, that I didn't speak clearly maybe on Thursday, folks misinterpreted what I said, but I never said there was a quid pro quo, because there isn't.
So back to the G7, the White House is now searching for a new location. President Trump suggested that Camp David might be an option. But just a few days ago, right here in that press conference here at the White House, Mick Mulvaney blasted Camp David as a disaster when past summits were held there. So, George, we are back to mixed messaging this morning.
That's for sure. And Cecilia, as you pointed out, the president blamed Democrats and the media for his reversal. But it was really pressure from Republicans that forced this decision.
Yeah, exactly. And we've just learned that over the weekend, Mulvaney held a meeting at Camp David with some Republicans where reportedly he was blasted on this one. Surely the president saw the headlines from this weekend that were basically saying the Republicans are tired of having to defend him over this G7 decision. George, of course, all of this coming at a time when he needs his team in his corner as he faces this impeachment inquiry.
He sure does, Cecilia. Thanks very much.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.